Hello, welcome to a short introduction on programmed instruction. I'm Jibrel Jose and I'll be taking this session. As a teacher, we would love our students to enjoy the journey of learning. We want them to drive on their own. We want them to be driven. We want them to be motivated. And we want them to feel a sense of satisfaction as they go through step by step. Now, in programmed instruction, it's something like a tutorial or maybe a workbook which is used in many places where the learner can go step by step. If needed, he can step back 2-3 steps and redo the sheets which he didn't understand. He could try out quizzes and exercises which make sense. He could take a remedial path where things are understood better. So it's a kind of a step-by-step approach. So let's try to understand what is programmed instruction. A programmed instruction is a method of self-instruction. Self is the keyword here. That enlists machine or specially prepared books to teach information. Now, this content is created by the teacher, and the teacher needs to put a lot of effort to create this content. It's maybe sometimes made as a team. And what is the purpose? We want human beings to be learning in a controlled environment. We want them to be learning in a pace which is comfortable for them. So maybe Rakesh will need to do it in 1 hour and Ramesh can do it in maybe 30 minutes. And each one can do that particular module in his own pace. Additionally, the whole content is divided into small chunks of easily digestible kind so that the learner can step by step understand, and slowly his understanding improves as time goes by. So this is the kind of things we want, the points to be taken care of when we make a programmed instruction. We want the end user to get quick responses. He able to ask a question, understand what the doubt is. So that kind of situation should happen within this learning module, which, keep in mind, is automatic. Maybe in terms of a book, maybe in terms of a tutorial, which is online. So now let's look at the different styles of programmed instruction. So like in this PPT, we can go to different parts by clicking the respective parts. So there are three subparts for programmed instructions. It could be a linear approach where we are step by step by step, and we start at some point and we end at point. And when we finish the end, our learning path is complete. In a branching style, sometimes, like I've shown in this particular sheet, this PowerPoint presentation from here could either go down linear programming, or it could go down the branching programming style, or it could go via the computer assisted instruction. So I could take this PPT in three different directions. It's also possible for me to maybe refer to the notes by clicking on this cloud of question mark here. So let's see what is linear programming's principles. So linear programming has a principle called everything should be in small steps. A concept of confirmation that, you know, if the person feels confident, he can move on to the next part himself. He doesn't need to wait for the teacher to come and take the class. He can move on to the next chapter in the book. Maybe he can move on to the next tutorial online. A principle of self-pacing. People can do it at different paces. You know, earlier there used to be a concept of books called Learn Visual Basic in 21 days. You know, and then somebody came up with a book, Learn It in 21 Hours. So the question of how much time does it take? Does it take 21 days to learn a programming language? Does it take 1 day to learn a programming language? So that approach, the pace can be decided by the learner. From the branching point of view, also there are some principles which we recommend. One is called the principle of exposition. So exposition means that you provide the whole picture. I mean, though you provide the small parts, but on the same hand, the whole thing is also understood by the end user. The principle diagnosis that, you know, end of the day, the user is able to introspect, find out whether he's learning, is he learning enough, can he speed it up? Because end of the day, we may have some automatic tests or quizzes and all in between, but the user also has to get a pulse of whether he's understanding the content. The third step is, in the case of branching, is because you have an option to, you know, have a conditional change and path shift, there is an option to do remedial teaching. So suppose if there somebody didn't understand a particular concept, let's say you are teaching photosynthesis and the child has not understood it. So the tutorial will take him through another path in which the thing will be explained in a different way. Now, if you simply go back and explain the same concept one more time, it may work, but it may not be the best. Now, I am doing this to show you how a PPT can be created. We can go back, a hyperlink is created, we can go back to the earlier page. We could go to the notes section straight away. And if you look in the notes section, these are notes made by me for the end semester, mid-sem exam for the students. Because on one side, I try to teach in a way so that students learn the application side of it. They do creativity, they do attempt things themselves. And these notes are for those students who need to also, you know, complete the syllabus, understand all the theories behind it. So these two-pager notes will summarize program instruction unit 2 of our syllabus quite, I feel, effectively. It gives all the short points, principles of linear programming, principles of branching program, types of PI, techniques of branching. We could do backward branching, we could do forward branching. In our example of the hierarchy, we had done a forward branching in one place and later we had a back button where we had done a backward branching. Okay. The phases of development of this instruction could be preparation, writing, validation. Okay. One more sheet of notes is there in which further notes are there. This same PDF will be provided to the students. Please check your WhatsApp group and you will be able to study the theory behind programmed instruction. You are all expected to attempt one assignment where you will be making one program instruction based learning content for a child in school. You will take one topic and try to make the content interesting so that you can engage the student in learning one simple concept. Ideally, this assignment may take between 1 to 2 hours to complete. And the number of slides we are talking about may range from 10 slides to max of 20 slides. Yeah. So thank you. With that, we come to the end of this short video on programmed instruction. Thank you.